What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my page and welcome back to another great workout. I know I say that often, but it's true. All right, guys, I'm super excited, if you can't tell, because we have a brand new workout, brand new format, and I am super stoked about it. Okay, welcome to Fire Up. So in Fire Up, here's what you can expect to see. We have 45 minutes of work in total length, right? Now, if you're a Patreon subscriber, you're gonna get the full 45. However, if you're not on Patreon, you're only gonna get about the first block. However, it's still gonna be a great workout, and I'll talk more about it. In fact, let's talk about it right now. So within each block, you're gonna see three different exercises. Exercise one is going to last for 30 seconds. It's all about high intensity work there, right? From there, you have about 10 seconds to transition to exercise number two. Exercise number two is gonna be double the amount of time, 1 minute of work. So we're looking for endurance type of strength training. Then you're gonna come into exercise number three, which is gonna be your longest block. That one is going to last for 90 seconds. So you'll have 30 seconds, 60 seconds, 90 seconds. When we come into the 90 second work, we're gonna do in a ladder formation, meaning that you're gonna do one repetition, then you'll do two repetitions, you'll do three repetitions, as many as you possibly can until you reach your final amount within that 90 second work. Now, whatever you see once, you're gonna see two more times before we move on to the brand new block. Now, if it seems a little confusing, don't even worry about it. As we start to move, it'll make way more sense. But for now, you need a couple different things. First thing you want is make sure you have yourself a clean area. Of course, you wanna have your mat. Also, make sure you have yourself a heavy set of dumbbells and a more moderate set of dumbbells. Your heavy set of dumbbells are gonna come into play when we come into that second exercise. Your more moderate exercises are going to be needed for the third exercise, because that one's gonna be really start to burn and build on it, right? I think that's pretty much it. Obviously, make any modifications that you may possibly need, but at the end of this, I really just want you guys to have fun with it, because it's supposed to be really fun. Fitness is fun, so that's why we smile all the time. Like, you see the smile? It's fun. All right, guys, let's go ahead and get this body warmed up, shall we? I'm gonna change off the music, and we're gonna get yourself started. Find yourself behind your mat. Walk your feet a little bit wider than shoulder distance apart, and here we go. All right, feet are wide. We have rotations, guys, side to side. Take a little tension off your lower middle back. Give me four more rotations here. Three more. Give me two more. Now hold to the center, give me some hip openers. We're gonna alternate between right side and left side, pulling the knee in towards the heart and circling it back out. Give me just four more repetitions. This is one. This is two. That's three. Number four, side lunges, side to side. We go to the right. Then we switch over to the other side. Sit your hips straight back, bending the knee, opening up that middle part of your thigh. You need four more, three more, two more. Meet me in center, give me a squat for me right here. We bend the knees, stand up tall. Drop and lift. You're dropping that tail, keeping your heart beautifully lifted. Give me four more. This is one, next two, this is three. Remember those side lunges? Let's do it again, let's take it to the side. Side, then switch. Do that again. Side and switch. Now you're gonna see fight lunges in today's workout, so this is a good opportunity for us to perfect that form. One more each side. Center squat for me right here. Take the bend, lift up tall. Squeezing the booty at the very top as you stand. Now you're gonna show me just four more right here. This is one. Makes two. This is three. Last one. Bring your hands above your head. Big exhale. Inhale, reach up the toes. Exhale to the ceiling. That again. Reach it down. Reach it up. So we're trying to loosen up those hamstrings. I'm going to do a small part turn just so you can actually see me. Take it down. Reach it up a little bit faster right here. Take it low. Reach it up. Really opening up those hamstrings. We got some glute work in today's workout. So this is a chance for us to get a little mobility there. A little blood flow. Two more. Last one. Stay low. Tuck your chin to your chest. Shake your head low. No, you will not give up today. Now you're gonna say yes. Yes, today is going to be the day you work harder. Bend the knees, hands to the floor. Walk both feet back, join me in plank. Hold this plank position. 1 foot forward outside the hand. Walk foot forward, hand to the ceiling, hand to the floor, set back downward on the other side. Step it out, reach it up, and comes down, downward dog, a little bit back. Here we go. Step, reach. Now, once you give me a beautiful exhale, every time you take that, you'll reach the ceiling. Again, step,
You got it. You're gonna need to feel those hips and need to open up here. Give me just a few more. Step, reach. Give me just one more. We're gonna hold your downward dog for me, guys. Bend one knee, press the left heel forward, forward. Switch to the side. Press it down. And switch a little bit faster. So go to the low one. And two. One. And two. Four more. Four. Three. Two. Both heels to the floor. Walk those finger or your feet. Push it towards your fingertips. Bend your knees. Roll up tall. Give me some butt kickers right here. Now you hold on to your butt kickers and shake out your wrists. As I explained, block one, exercise one. Block number one, exercise one. We're gonna start with squat jumps. So right off the bat, we're gonna get the heart rate high, fire up those legs from the ground up, all right? Now if you're not jumping today, of course keep those feet on the floor, but otherwise I wanna see just a little bit of air time on this one, guys. Okay, walk yourself to your space real area. Walk your feet about hip distance apart. We bend those knees, we stand up, we explode. In three, two, 30 seconds, here we go, down and up. 30 seconds, leaving the floor, softening the knees, absorbing on the way down. You got it, down and up. We're striking up that metabolism, getting the heart rate a little bit higher, right from the start, 15 seconds. Come on. All those squats we did during that warm up, they're gonna help here to fire us up. Give me eight, four, three, two, one. Grab onto your heavy set of dumbbells right here. Heavy dumbbells. We're gonna have 1 minute on the clock. One curtsy, one back lunge. Ready, set, here we go. Take one curtsy, same foot, coming to that back lunge. Do that again. Cross it back, lunge it back. Now in these curtsies, I'm simply looking for the foot to go into the back diagonal. Keep the shoulders beautifully square and belly button in towards your spine. Now chances are, breath may start catching up to you here, especially after that first set of power. We came out like a cannon, guys. Woo. Okay, 30 seconds. Right now, glutes will start to sing to you, or at least be like, what's going on upstairs, right? 15 more seconds. Cross it back. Lunge it back. 15 more seconds. Stay with me, guys. Four, three, two, one. Pick up your more modern set of hand weights. Okay, we have a curl, overhead press, tricep. Now we're looking for a ladder position, right? Which means each time you see each one of those movements, you add one more repetition. Start with our ones, the twos, it'll make sense as we go. Okay, here we go. One curl, one press, one tricep, comes all the way down. Now give me two curls. One, two, give me two presses. One, two, two triceps. Bend, straighten out, bend, straighten out. Okay, so now we move on to threes. I got one, two, three, three presses. One, two, three. Then those elbows, triceps. Now, your breathing may have started to come back down underneath control, which is good, right? You should take those opportunities to celebrate it. This is on number three, four. I got four presses. One, two, three, four. I got triceps. Now, this is our opportunity to really start to focus on that form, guys. Here comes number five for me. Where are you at? Arms start to get nice and heavy now. Boom. Two. Three. Four. Five. So now you know why we use those more modern dumbbells versus going for those heavy ones right off the bat, right? Because we got a long way to go on this one. One. Yeah, 10 more seconds. Two. Three. Four. Five. 5 seconds. You're about to find a 20 or 30 second recovery, right? Now, recover. Okay, check it out. So for me, I was able to get 6 curls in there. So when I come into round number 2, which is gonna be here very, very soon, my goal is to either meet or beat that number of repetitions as I come back in, right? Right now,
Breathing should feel back underneath control. Arms still feel a little heavy, but it's okay because we're about to go into that first exercise, which is our legs. Powerful in 3, 2 squat jumps. Here we go. 30 seconds, guys. Little push from the floor. Give me some air time. Get up. Bend and explode. Now I like to let my arms help me as I catapult right back up. I suggest you do the same. 10 seconds. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1 Recover. We got 10 seconds. Grab onto those heavy dumbbells. My bells are 25 dumbbells. Or 25 pounds, not 25 dumbbells. Curtsy, back lunge. Here we go. Curtsy. Right to the back lunge. Down again. Curtsy it back. Sit into that lunge. Now, as I take my curtsy, I'm looking to keep my shoulders over top of the hips. So when I load into that curtsy, I can feel all the work into my back pocket. Same thing when I come into that back lunge. I'm putting my shoulders down and back, making the work for me. So, these second exercises, this is as many repetitions as possible. When we come to third, this is as many rounds as possible. 10 more seconds. So today on ramp, just look through a different lens. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 Recover. Okay, 20 seconds to recover here, guys. Note, how many repetitions did you do the first time through? Can you beat or beat that number? I know for me, it was 6 curls. So I got some work to do. All right, kids, ready? 3, 2, here we go. 1 curl, press, right side tricep. I'll do that again. Curl, 2 times. Press, 2 times. Tricep, 2 times. Keeping those elbows nice and pinned, close to my torso. When I take that shoulder press, I'm gonna keep the dumbbells facing fingertips towards each other. It's a little bit more shoulder friendly. So if you guys are dealing with shoulder issues, I suggest you take this more narrow approach. But if you wanna hit a different side of your shoulders, you can always go out to wide, right? And I'll show you this one on right here. This is number 5 for me. 2, 3, 4, 5 5. So this is the difference, right? So if you go out to more wide, 2, that's 5. All right. I can definitely start to feel arms get a little bit more heavier. Hey, I'm on number 6 curls, and I got 20 seconds left. 5, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 I got 7 seconds left. 3, 2, 1 Recover. Woo. All right, shake out those arms. How we do? I beat my first round, but now I have a brand new goal, right? I was able to get right to about 5 triceps. So my goal here is, with good quality form, can I beat that number? Quality over quantity, guys. I don't want to see you just flinging those dumbbells in space. All right, last time for these squat jumps. Let's knock them out. 3, 2, 1 Here we go. You got 30 seconds. Right back on the dial. The good news is, when we take these big power pushes, we have a longer recovery. So, when we do come in to your next round, you're nice and ready to go because you've had a longer recovery. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1 Recover. Woo. All right, it's high. Okay, guys, it's dumbbells. Heavy dumbbells. Curtsy, lunge. Ready? Here we go. I curtsy. I take my lunge. Other side.
shoulders square. Can you drop your back knee 2 inches lower, down towards that floor? Up. Boom. Drop it, lift it. Cross the back. Really feel all that work deep into the glute and center thigh. Hello. Think curtsy there. Come back down low. Now this is the last time I'm gonna see this motion. So I need to own it, right? I want you to own it with me. How low can you get? Less than 10 seconds. We're bringing it home, guys. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. 20 seconds to recover. Woo. All right. My goal, to get those triceps, meet or beat 5 triceps, quality reps. If you got with me, great. Ready? Let's go. That's 1 time through. Focus on the form of your guys. Yes, there is a time limit, but again, I'm looking for quality over quantity. It doesn't count if they look sloppy, right? If you need to, take those recovery times, then join back in. The great thing about this particular workout in this medium is that we get to go on your time, guys. Let's work and we'll move over. So, you can always come back to this motion or come back to this workout anytime and see how far you progress. That's the great thing about this, right? We now have measurable ways of seeing our progression. And one of those ways is being able to see how strong we can be and how many repetitions we can make within a given amount of time. 20 seconds, here's number 6. Woo! Gonna build this one tomorrow. I gotta get some 6. 5, 4, 3, 2. I got 10 seconds left to get at least 6 triceps for my own personal goal. But where are you at? 4, 5, 6. Just under the wire. Done. Woo! All right, kids. How did we do? Pretty good, right? Not bad? Okay, real virtual fist bump. I love it.
It. I loved it. You guys did so good. That, ladies and gentlemen, was Fire Up. I'm so happy that you could join me. It was incredible. Let's cool down this body and get ourselves ready. All right, you can stay kneeling here. Begin to bend the elbows, tug them forward. You can even move your arms. Roll them back. Take a generous inhale, reach those hands above your head. Interlace the fingers. Lean over to one side. Take it over to the other side. That beautiful side stretch. Step 1 foot forward, doesn't matter which side you push. Press the hips forward, feel that beautiful stretch into your hip flexor. One arm down, one low arm. And then turn over that bent knee. Back into the center, same thing onto the other side. Foot forward, shift it forward, feel that beautiful stretch in front of your hip flexor. One hand down, reach it over. And then simply twist over that side. Back into the center, both hands and knees down. Take a big inhale, round the back, tuck the tail. Exhale, draw the shoulders down. Do that again, big inhale, round the back. Exhale, lengthen the spine. One more time, round the back. And exhale, draw the shoulders down. Okay, flex both of the toes, press hips up high to the ceiling. Start to massage the heels down towards the floor. Feel that generous stretch behind the hamstrings and the calves. We did a lot with those hamstrings, with those deadlifts,
and those bridges for our glutes. So this is a nice opportunity to sort of open it up. Tiptoe the feet closer towards your hands. Shift your weight back into your heels. Start to shift side to side, wagging the tail. Tucking the chin to the chest, releasing the head back to shoulders. Full center, shake the head go. Not the head rest. Bend the knees, roll all the way up.
Take a big inhale, reach those hands up. Exhale, let it go. Hey, thank you so much for coming in. You guys, you killed it. That right there was Fire Up. I hope you loved it. I loved having you. I will see you next time. Be very good to yourselves and to each other.